Then a fairies pulled them down. Some of the best music was composed by Beethoven. What was his handicap? Was deaf. Even he was a deaf, but for a musician, how pathetic it would be. Some of the best poem written on nature was written by Milton. What was his handicap? He was blind. For a writer, it is blind. How pathetic it would be. Friends, let's share the story of Wilma Rudolph. Wilma was born into a poor family in Tennessee. At age of 4, she had double pneumonia and scarlet fever, a deadly combination which left her with polio. She has to wear braces. And doctor said that she never would keep her foot on the earth. But her mother encouraged her a lot by saying that God has given you ability, persistence and faith. You can do whatever you want. Then Wilma said that, I want to be the fastest lady on the earth. Then at the age of 9, she removed the braces against the doctor's advice and took her first step on the earth. Then doctor said that she never would. At the age of 13, she entered into the first race. And came way well lost. Then again she entered into the second and third and fourth races and she came way well lost. Until the day came when she was at the first. At the age of 15, she went to the Tennessee State University and where she met the coach named Edward Temple. She said to him, I want to be the fastest woman on the track on this earth. Then he said that, with your spirit, no one can stop you. Besides, I will help you. The day came when she was at the Olympics. And you are going to be matched with the best of the best. Wilma was matched with a woman named Jutta Hen. And she had never been beaten with anyone. The first event was 100 meters race. In that, Wilma beat Jutta and got her first gold medal. The second event was 200 meters race. And once again, Wilma beat Jutta and got her second gold medal. The third event was 400 meters relay. Here, once again, Wilma was matched with Jutta. And in this relay, the first three women passed their batons very easily. But now it's Wilma's turn. Wilma dropped her baton. And she saw that Jutta had shot up at the other end. Then she picked up the baton and ran like a machine. It became history that a paralytic woman was the fastest woman on the track on this earth in 1960 Olympics. Friends, what's the lesson learned from Wilma's story? The successful people do it in spite of, not in the absence of problems. If we read or hear the stories like this, like the people, those who changed their adversities into opportunities, won't they motivate us? If you regularly go on reading such biographies and autobiographies of those great people, won't we be motivated? At last, I want to conclude my seminar with saying that when Milton could write the best poem on the nature, being blind,